Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. Well, as we saw earlier, the Heart Foundation's funding a study into Māori and Pasifika people and why so many die of a major heart event. It's an area of increasing concern for our people, and here to talk more about this, plus the Stoptober campaign, is Louisa Ryan and Edward Cowley from the Heart Foundation. Thanks for joining us. Well, first of all, Louisa, I know the study is going to be looking at why we are of such high risk with heart problems, but how is this research going to help?
I'm really excited about Karina's research because we have really good care. We know all the data around the risks and there's available treatment. But for some reason, our Pacific people, as Karina has identified, we are kind of not getting the treatment earlier, and therefore we're arriving at the hospital very sick and we're dying from a heart attack as opposed to other.
Edward, you're seeing, you know, from your experience out in the community, why are our people dying so?
I guess a lot of it is around information and sort of our health literacy. So how can we improve the health literacy of our people to recognise that when they're unwell or if something happens to them, how they can seek help and go to the doctor and get and become well sooner?
Yeah. Okay, then. What about our health, our lifestyle? Are we eating, could we be eating a lot healthier?
We could be doing a lot of better lifestyle, for example. Stop smoking, have a healthy diet, moderate, and keep your healthy weight, moderate exercise, and of course keep your blood pressure low, have normal blood pressure. So a lot of those kind of risks to heart disease we can manage better, but we don't.
Okay, so. And some of those things, like culturally, I'm just thinking for myself, I know I eat way too much white rice. I'm just thinking, is there a lot of education that needs to be done in terms of what's good or what's bad or how much we should be eating?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it is about portion control, because for us, our normal portions are much bigger than the Pākehā's normal pālangi, normal
way
portions.
Bigger.
So, and we actually don't need all that food, but because we're so used to it, that's our normal. So how do we change our normal and get our people to understand, actually, it's great that we can eat, but we actually don't need all that food. Let's just cut it right back down. We're still going to survive when we're being healthy. Absolutely we will. And you know, that was a lesson that took for me to learn, because I used to eat really big portions. Yeah. But, you know, over a period of time, it's actually, I brought it down. All I've affected the change within my family to get them to understand that actually we don't need all that. So that's where the change needs to start. It needs to start with us. It needs to start with us at home. It needs to start with us in our communities.
And I know that you've even had a young child. Tell us about that 8-year-old who came into the Heart Foundation.
Yeah, there's a young child that's quite obese, obviously for 8 years old, over 100 kilograms.
Over 100 kg.
Yes, and there are a lot of children similar situation.
From our island community.
Yeah, in our Pacific communities. And the unfortunate aspect of that story is that the parents, especially the mom, did not think that her child was overweight. The obesity in Pacific is being normalised, unfortunately. And again, as Edward mentioned, we go to our church and social environment and we don't just, you know, it's a cultural thing that we kind of...
We see like the big taros and the kumaras and big
heavy plates. You honour your visitors your guests by giving them that, but we don't have to. You know, there's no need to put so much food on the table.
It's a new tradition. Mm. We never used to eat like that back in the island. It is a new cultural, you know. Traditions change and they evolve. So we never used to eat like that. Let's get back to how we used to eat in the old days.
We seriously need to look at managing all that food and obesity for our children. We've got very, very obese young people. And, you know, you have a fat child or a child that's, you're going to get someone that's going to grow up with heart disease, with diabetes and all.
And that's the other thing that we're seeing a lot of our people dying really young, and it's becoming more normal, 50-year-olds dying,
For heart disease, we've got Māori and Pacific male are now having their heart attacks in the 40-60 year age bracket, whereas mainstream, you know, you will have heart disease, you know, often, but it's your later age.
I want to really quickly get into exercise, because I know I see your Facebook updates all the time, but you didn't always used to, you know, be really...
No, absolutely not. It was something that I learned to do, and you know, and you can, you know, I mean, I used to be a smoker as well, so all those things that were normal when I was growing up that I thought were okay to do, but as you sort of get older, you know, it's a moderation in everything. So exercise, and even if it's just going for a walk, but actually taking that time to build in some exercise into your daily routine will help bring your heart, you know, this will help bring your heart health down.
Okay.
Absolutely it will.
Well, I'm going to start today. Thank you. Thanks for coming in, both of you. Appreciate
just,
your time
just one
today.
More thing for, if you've got time. I urge our people that if you're getting to really understand the medication that you've been given, because a lot of the time the prevention and the treatment is about the drugs that you're taking, and a lot of the time we don't do that.
So okay,
talk
understand
to your
that
health
too.
Worker.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Pop day, Lassie.